let's not make any mistake about what is happening. Saudi Arabia, with its huge wealth, is sport washing the world.
Well, nobody's gotten to the bottom of 9/11, unfortunately, and they should have.
They bought golf! Exclamation point.
Frankly, what they're doing for golf is so great. What they're doing for the players is so great. The salaries are going to go way up.
Golf couldn't resist the cash, which speaks louder than any human rights group.
They literally bought golf completely. Yeah. They're now trying to buy the best Premier League football in the world, which of course is here in the United Kingdom. It's throughout Europe, and they will do it.
The quote is, when someone tells you who they are, believe them. Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman would discuss how in the past, oil served the country well. However, he says it worked when the country was much smaller. There are over 35 million people now, and it is time to cash in. In turn,
this will help Saudi Arabia's plan to have a more diverse economy that doesn't only rely on oil.
We learned of Vision 2030 through the Crown Prince's own well, vision, investing about $7 trillion in the initiative, with the biggest targets set for the world of sports.
Cristiano Ronaldo has completed his move to Saudi Arabian side Al Nassr.
French player N'Golo Kante is heading to Saudi Arabia.
Benzema is the latest soccer megastar to join Cristiano Ronaldo in the Saudi League.
The list goes on and on and on. Huge names in the world of soccer flocking to a country with an atrocious human rights record for money. It shows the competition of funds in other top leagues with billionaire owners simply cannot match up to an entire country's government. However, throughout, the theme has been quite constant. How can players who have been outspoken on serious social issues then take the money from Saudi Arabia? Look no further than former Liverpool man Jordan Henderson. Henderson, who has donned the rainbow armband and been an advocate for marginalized communities, is the latest figure heading to the Middle East. Henderson is set to make £700,000 a week.
It's still criminal to be gay. Sexual activity between gay people is illegal. The maximum punishment is death.
Alexander Baker, chair of Stonewall, spoke with TalkSport when asked if Hendo can have an impact.
I doubt it in his remaining playing career. If you think back to Qatar last year, Jordan Henderson was one of many England players who were very vocal about their concerns about the Qatari regime, but their ability to do much in the tournament, as we all know, was pretty heavily circumscribed. Even if there aren't any explicit restrictions on him being a vocal advocate who does make the move, the environment in which he'll be operating isn't one where these sorts of issues are likely to be encouraged.
In addition, Liverpool's official LGBT plus fan group, Cop Outs, condemned the move by Hendo because, as Baker stated, being gay is illegal. Gay people are put to death for being who they are. He won awards for his companionship. He even rocked rainbow laces when he played. When asked why he wore them, he said this campaign is important if there are still supporters out there who don't feel they can be themselves, or even worse, have to hide who they are for fear of getting abused or being discriminated against. I'm a parent, a husband, a son, and a brother, and the idea that anyone I love and care about wouldn't feel safe or comfortable coming to watch me play if they were part of the LGBT community makes me wonder what world we live in. To give one an idea of the country's ruling class and their thoughts and policy on gay people, they banned Pixar's Lightyear because two characters in the movie, two women, kiss. Saudi, Malaysia, and other parts of the region came together in canceling the film's airing. The Athletic's Adam Crafton would put this quite well in his piece. There is nothing overly original or unique about this moment. Here's a famous person failing to practice as he preaches, encouraging the public to do as I say, not as I do. For some time, because sportsmen inspire a loyalty, devotion, and connection that few others can match, the pain will be sincere. To these people, Henderson will also earn an MBE for his services to charity. Really did seem different. For fans of clubs other than Liverpool, the criticism will be laced with truth, but also intensified by tribal one-upmanship where some may seek to opportunistically impose their own virtue. And here's the knockout punch from Crafton. Yes, this is about one man's perceived betrayal, but it is also about a moment in time where the silence of men's sport is increasingly bought on LGBTQI plus issues, just at the very moment when a renewed wave of global social authoritarianism and democratic backsliding gathers pace. And it's not just Henderson, it's those like Henderson who have said, how can we not speak out on this issue? How can we not bring light to this issue? And then what do? They take the money from that community's oppressors. The message remains consistent, very consistent. Sadly, unlike Jordan Henderson.
A number of players continue to be linked with a move to Saudi Arabia. Some players said to be already on their way. Others reported to be doing so. Jordan Henderson linked with Al Ettifaq, Fabinho linked with Al Ittihad, and Riyad Mahrez with Al Ahly. So these are the latest names that we are seeing.